welcome to the workshop.
I've taken time off from whatever the hell that is that I do to explain to you why the Indiana Jones style two-belly bullwhip is not an adequate zombie killer. I'm not disputing the accuracy of the whip, simply its power. Now you see that string I'm holding? That's called the cracker. That's the part that actually breaks the sound barrier and makes that bang. It's also the part that hits the target.
Ow. 10 grams, about the equivalent of 10 paper clips.
Did you hear that? The cracker weighs in at 10 grams. Okay, to start off, to break a human skull, you need about 90 psi worth of pressure. Now compare that to the calculated power of a bullet.
Yeah!
Now the way you measure force of impact is mass times acceleration divided by surface area. So, the bigger it is, the faster it is, and the smaller surface area all determines the force of impact. In this case, 10 grams, 1400 feet per second, divided by, because it's less than a square inch, 1/10 of a square inch of impact. So, 10 times 1400 times 10 again means 140,000 units of force. Divide that by 1,000 to bring it down into kilograms. Then divide by 2.2 to bring it into pounds, because we're going feet per second. We need to keep it at SI. You get 63.63 repeating PSI, about 2/3 of the minimum requirements to penetrate a human skull. But as a huge fan of the Mythbusters, now sadly no longer on the air, it still hurts. I know that if you want to actually prove something, you need to physically test it yourself. A zombie weapon should be able to do the job in one hit.
So, there you go. That's zombie goo right there. Don't tell the other people, but I put some green slime in a couple of these as opposed to just regular water. I don't even know how many hits that was. Probably something like 7. So, no joke. This is a serious, serious amount of damage. I wouldn't want to get hit with this thing. But the idea that it could do instantaneous lethal damage through bone is just not happening. Sorry.